Daily Devotion with Pastor Balla for November 29th, 2020, from Luke chapter 1, Zechariah. Today we begin a new church year, and it begins with the season of Advent. Advent is a time of preparation as we get ready for our Savior to come. God takes on human flesh and blood, and is born into this world in Bethlehem, whose birth we celebrate on December 25th. But for today, we back up from the birth of Jesus and start with Zechariah. To help us to better understand, it had been about 400 years since God had spoken by a prophet. Why so long? Well, you gotta remember, this is God's timing, not man's timing. From Luke chapter 1, verse 5, in the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the division of Abijah, and he had a wife from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. It actually first starts with Herod, and why Herod? Herod is a very good time spot, so that we know exactly when Herod ruled in Judah. And because of that, we know the timing of all of this. And that's how we can figure out the dates, that it's been about 400 years since God had spoken from a prophet. Not that God had forgotten the people. No, God still remembered, but God was waiting for God's reason. But now we get on with Zechariah. Zechariah means remembered by God. He was about one of, say, 20,000 priests during this time. His wife Elizabeth, the name Elizabeth means God her oath, like a worshiper of God. So both of them, by their name, were waiting for the Messiah to come. And both of them, by their practice, seem to also be eagerly waiting and patiently waiting. Zechariah was a priest who served God. Only certain people could be priests. You sort of had to be born into that family or tribe. And once you were born into that family or tribe, that's pretty much what you did. So let's continue on with verse 6. And they both were righteous before God, walking blamelessly in all the commandments and statutes of the Lord. Here in the Gospel of Luke, it clearly says that, yes, they were faithful to God. Both Elizabeth and Zechariah were faithfully waiting for the Messiah to come. But what happens when you're faithfully waiting, but things don't necessarily seem to be going the way you want them to go? What do I mean by that? Verse 7. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. God didn't bless them with a child. We need to remember as Christians that children are a gift from the Lord. Let's hear about this in Genesis chapter 30, verses 1 and 2. When Rachel saw that she bore Jacob no children, she envied her sister. She said to Jacob, "Give me children or I shall die." Jacob's anger was kindled against Rachel and said, "Am I in the place of God who has withheld from you the fruit of the womb?" You can see Rachel's anger and her frustration. Yes, for the people of God and for all people, we cherish these gifts of children. And when the Lord doesn't give us that gift of children, especially as Jacob responds and says, "Am I in the place of God?" These children are a gift from God. It can be a lot of pain and struggle for the couple who is struggling with the anger and the frustration of infertility. But we need to remember that God is truly the author of all life. Our faithfulness to God is not because of the many gifts that God has given to us. Our faithfulness to God is by faith, which is a gift we receive from God. And we don't allow the gifts or the lack of gifts from this world pull us away from that beautiful gift of faith. Zachariah and Elizabeth both knew this and were still faithful to God, even though the hope of a child was diminishing with each passing year. So it's interesting that as we begin our preparations for the annual celebration of Christmas, the incarnation of God who takes on flesh and blood, remembering this little baby, Jesus, born to Mary, we actually begin with a couple who doesn't have a child? Yes, it had been about 400 years since the people of God were contacted by God through a prophet. And Zachariah and Elizabeth were waiting patiently, along with other people, for God to make contact again, to send a Messiah. You see, the faithful always know that God keeps his promises and fulfills his promises in his time, not our time. Join me again tomorrow as we hear about the long shot. Approximately 1 out of 20,000. Now that's a long shot. God's peace and many blessings be with you. Thank you for watching, and please take an opportunity to share this message with others. If you have enjoyed these daily devotions, please consider making a donation to Peace Lutheran Church, 24024 West Main Street, Plainfield, Illinois, 60544. Thank you again for watching.